Greetings, Mount Pleasant family. Pastor Jay here from my office at the Mount with some announcements and updates on this Sunday, April 26, 2020. What a powerful word from our bishop this morning, reminding us of the importance of the resurrection today. I don't have time to tell you how much I miss you and love you, but know this, after this pandemic crisis is over, we will win. We already have the victory, but I just wanted to remind you that we are going to win. To God be the glory. Our list of deaths in our family is increasing. We're in sympathy with Sister Hazel Teal and the passing of her husband, our friend and brother, Bradley Butch Teal. We're in sympathy with Sister Dawn Miner and the passing of her mother. We're in sympathy with Brother Greg Braxton and Sister Gloria Braxton and the passing of their sister, Bernice Bishop. We're also in sympathy with Sister Ruby Winkler and the passing of her husband, Leroy Pete Winkler. Let's keep our church family in prayer for those whose family members have transitioned from earth to glory. To show our care and support for our grieving members, we have posted a tribute movie clip expressing our condolences from the bishop, the pastors, the official board, leaders, and the entire Mount Pleasant family. I hope you have seen it on our social media pages. Beloveds, this virus has started to really hit close to home and is affecting our loved ones. Please pray a special prayer for the following affected with COVID-19. Let's be praying for Sister Cheryl Blue Samuel and son who are infected with coronavirus. Sister Cheryl is now recovering well. Also, Brother Rodell Bailey L., his wife, Sister Kia Bailey L., has tested positive with COVID-19. They are both doing well at this time. Let's be praying for those families and others who are dealing with this terrible virus. Also, keep Mother Lily Scott in your prayers. All of her toes on her left foot were amputated. She is recovering well in Good Samaritan Hospital. Before I let you go, I've got a couple of reminders and notices. Remember that Mount Pleasant is a registered site for the Maryland Food Bank. Our hours of operation are Tuesday through Friday from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. Our admin office will be open during that time to assist you in any way we can. We are here for you. We're also preparing for your return. We have ordered the PPE equipment and items. We're also creating entry procedures and setting up stations for evaluations. Your return and our return to the sanctuary is imminent, and we will be here soon. So we are preparing for your safety and health during this pandemic crisis. Notice, listen up, Mount Pleasant. The June 17th bus trip to Sight and Sound to see Queen Esther has been canceled. There is no rescheduled date. For more information, please email your mailing address and phone number to Sister Tanya Cato at tcato@mountpleasant.org. Again, please email your mailing address and phone number to tcato@mountpleasant.org. Finally, Romans 13, 1 and 2 urges us to honor the executive orders from the governing bodies in our state and the White House. And we follow those mandates if they are not in opposition to God's word. However, I am certain the verses in Romans 13 do not intend for us to be haphazard or foolish. I know we want an end to this coronavirus, but we must take pause when the president insinuates we ingest disinfectants and UV rays into our bodies to get rid of COVID-19. Now, I know I don't have to say this to our family because we are too wise for that foolishness. I only mention this for us to chuckle and dismiss this ridiculous suggestion from the White House. Fox News says he was only being sarcastic. Really? I think we all know better. Let's end this announcement time with a big happy birthday to everybody born in the month of April. Happy birthday! And may you have many, many more. Mount Pleasant, this ends our announcements, so I want to leave this with you. God bless you, and remember to practice good social distancing. Until the next time, walk with the King, and be a blessing. Stay safe.